And the word is translated pestilence. Pestilence. That caught me. I was like, whoa. I actually said it out loud. I was studying this. And my wife, I said, wow, this is crazy. This is good. This is incredible. They spoke to one another. They commanded one another. They encouraged one another. They sang to one another. They warned one another. They threatened one another. The threats were this. Hey, listen, if you continue on a road of wickedness, there's going to be recompense. But if you fear the name of the Lord and you honor him, as we see the law of the Lord laid out in the scriptures, often it's conjoined with righteous action, as if the two could be synonymous, the fear of the Lord and obedience to his commands. They run parallel. They run side by side. They're friends. To fear the Lord is to honor the Lord, is to obey the Lord. That's why Jesus said, if you love me, you'll keep my commandments. A true love for God is a reverential fear. It's not an emotional, mushy type of love that we've made it in much of our modern Christianity. A true love for God equates to a transformation in our life where our desire is to honor and esteem. Not just, I love you, but I don't honor you. Jesus says, you don't love me if you don't honor me and obey me. That God wants us to walk in his will and his ways, because his desire for his people is that they would be blessed. How many people believe that? That God's desire for his people is blessing. Amen? That's God's desire. His desire, because he said, I've made you. In fact, he said, I bore you on eagle's wings. Now, these are the same people that didn't honor him or his word in the wilderness for 40 years. He said, I bore you up on eagle's wings. I brought you out. I didn't let any of you experience all the death plagues of Egypt. You didn't touch any of those things because I set you apart to be a special possession, but they couldn't get it. They couldn't translate it into actual action. Moses here up on the mountain receiving the Ten Commandments because the people thought, you know, if you give us some strict commands, we'll know what to do. And they didn't have any desire to really do these things. And it's important that we see when all these things break forth around us, you know what a true test is? It's the test of our heart. Where's our heart at? Do we really believe God? Do we really desire to honor God? Or are we looking for fire insurance? Are we looking to get out of trouble when trouble comes? Or do we really have a love for God and a reverential awe for him that no matter come hell or high water, I'm going to esteem the name of God. I'm going to esteem the name of Jesus Christ. That's the reality when tough times come. The reality is this, when we're all pressed in these positions where no one's comfortable, the true test is going to take place of who you really are, what's really on the inside. When you're pressed, it's really going to start coming out. Is it fear in there? Fear will come out. Is it faith in there? Faith will come out. If you believe God, that's if the word of God has been placed in and you have meditated upon the word of God, guess what? In times of trial, the word of God is going to come out. That's a reality. It is. God wants his people to thrive in the midst of difficult circumstances. And I found it interesting as they spoke one to another. Now is the time not to be quiet. Now is the time to speak up. Now is the time to open up your mouths and let your voices be heard on high. Now is the time to praise your Redeemer and to thank him for all his faithfulness and blessing that adds no sorrow to it. That you thank God that his protection is upon your life, that you speak the word of God over your life, that you use your mouth as an instrument, that you don't stay silent. Fear will creep in when you stay silent. That's why you need to lift up your voice in praise to the God who's worthy of all our praise. Amen. That you would lift up your voice to one another and encourage and remind the call of God, what you've been called. You're a special possession. You're the apple of God's eye. God has redeemed you and established you for his own namesake. Don't fall into the trap. Continue to walk on. Encourage one another. Speak to one another. Let there be fear in the midst of God's people, and we'll honor God. And in the midst of God's people honoring one another, finding that faith, people that believe God, getting around people. I believe at the end of this thing, God's going to add to the number of this assembly, because you know why? We have a group of people here who believe God at his word, who are open to him for his promise, and people are hungry for a God that works. People are hungry for a God who works. And our God works. Our God is a God of power. Our God, a God, has revealed himself in his son, Jesus Christ, that death itself could not hold him down. You might close the doors on Easter Sunday, but you cannot close the doors to heaven because the grave has already been opened up. Heaven has been opened up. And God's people are going to walk in His blessing. There's a power that's going to emanate through God's people as they begin to surround themselves with each other and begin to speak one to another. It's time to use our voices, folks. It's time to lift up our voices. It's not the time to be silent. Now is the time to speak the word of God. Now is the time to declare the word of His promise. Now is the time to encourage. Call somebody. Get on the phone this afternoon. Call somebody. They might be struggling. Say, listen, God's still on the throne, and He still loves you. You might feel like worthless, but you're not worthless. In God's eyes, you are a special possession. You are a treasure. You are a jewel. You have been set apart for His purposes. And stop living beneath that and giving into that which ultimately is going to lead to destruction. Get back into the place and the path of life. Amen.